Saya juga ada terangkan kepada anak-anak saudara saya. Saya cakap, Mak B dah tak boleh mandikan kakak dah. Kakak dah besar. Kakak kena mandi sendiri. Kalau keluar bilik air, kena pakai tuala. Jangan bogil-bogil. So, when you explain to them, you have to explain the why as well. Sebab nanti dia tak faham. Dia nak ikut tu sebab apa. So, you kena explain. Cakaplah kata, kena tutup vagina. Tak boleh tunjuk ke orang. Bahaya. Nanti orang buat apa-apa. So, when you explain all these things, they are able to understand and they are able to prevent themselves from being hurt by anyone in the future. Any touch that is without consent is considered as a harassment. That is why before you touch someone, you have to ask for their permission. Walaupun sebenarnya tangan ni dikira sebagai safe area, kan? Tangan, bahu. Tapi ianya boleh dikira sebagai unsafe areas kalau you tak minta kebenaran. Contohnya macam you tiba-tiba pergi pegang dan orang tu tak selesa. So itu kira harassment lah. Stranger danger and teaching kids safe and unsafe touch are applicable for both male and female children, boys and girls. It's not just girls, boys pun boleh kena sexually assaulted and molested. I know I don't have kids. I know some people might be thinking that, oh, this is not your place to be talking about this, but I will explain the reason why I think it's important for you to teach this as soon as possible. I don't want more kids in the future to face what I faced when I was little. So what happened when I was little was I was sexually assaulted by my neighbor. This happened when I was 6 years old. I think it was back in 1990 something. What happened was he invited me in. I wasn't alone at the time. He asked my brother and I to watch porn with him. And then he brought us to his room and I think he wanted to initiate something but he didn't manage to. My body reacted even though I couldn't understand what happened. Nobody has ever taught me about safe and unsafe touch. So I didn't know what he did was actually sexual assault until I was old enough. My brain couldn't comprehend what was happening because I wasn't taught about stranger danger. I wasn't taught about safe and unsafe touch. But my body understood, so there were physiological changes. I threw up in my sleep that night. I had a very bad fever. I remember telling my parents that this neighbor did this and that, and then they said that there's no way he would actually do that. What happened now is, even though the trauma was 20 plus years ago, I still remember, and because of that now I am living with mental illnesses. And I don't know whether the guy is actually watching this video or not, but I hope he does, and I hope he knows the repercussions of his action, and I hope the same thing wouldn't happen to his daughter and son.